What type of breast implant is the best?
Hi, I'm Dr. Joe Griskavits. They usually call me Dr. Joe or Dr. G, and I'm a board-certified plastic surgeon. And you know, the question was, what is the best type of breast implant? And I don't really feel there is a best type of breast implant. I think each surgeon has their familiarity and their favorites, but there's different types, and of course there's only a few companies that make the implants, so there's good quality control and the FDA regulates all this. So I guess I wouldn't say there's the best. But here's the differences. For example, the saltwater implants were what was used and allowed between 1992 and November 16, 2006. The saltwater or saline implants are less expensive, but they can wrinkle a little bit more, and they might not feel as natural. It's more like a water balloon as opposed to a softer breast. And they can rupture. Of course, if they rupture, then you take it out and put in a new one. And these can be inserted through a smaller incision because they're deflated first and then inflated inside the body. Also, the thing with the saltwater implants is if you have a size difference from one breast to the other, that's a minor difference, you can more easily adjust for that. Whereas with the silicone implants, they come pre-filled. So in terms of a little bit of difference in size, you can't really adjust for that, but that isn't really like a real big problem because if there's a big difference, then you just put in a different size silicone implant. So this is the silicone. You tend to have less wrinkles that would show through if you have wrinkles at all. It tends to feel more natural, but it's more expensive, and you have to put it in through a larger incision. Now, I'm sure I have some ruptured silicone implants in people, but I don't know that I do. Whereas the saltwater implant, if it ruptures, this will deflate overnight. So there's a kind of the differences there. Also, you've heard about the gummy bear implants or shaped implants. So a shaped implant has a little bit more of an anatomical look where it's larger on the bottom and thinner on the top. This is a round textured implant. I like the textured implants for people that are bodybuilders and competitors because with the muscle action, an implant can over the years move down, especially if you're lifting weights frequently. So this one stays in place more from the texture. There is a study that's going to be coming out in our journal shortly that showed patients had a round implant on one side and a textured on the other. I don't know how the ethics committee let that through, but they did. And 75 patients were evaluated by 9 board certified plastic surgeons and they could not see any difference. And of course, this one's $1,000 more. So you can make your own decision on that one. And also in my book, Your Body, Your Beauty, Your Safety, I discuss the differences between the saline implants and the silicone and the textured and so forth. When you do go through the implants in the office, you do want to look at your warranties for like salt water or for the silicone. Get all your notes and books together for that one. And then there's a size table where you have different sizes for the gel, silicone, or for the saline salt water. And then in terms of picking your implants, you can look at patients and see what they had, what sizes they had, and how this would fit your body. And make sure you see a surgeon who does the quick recovery approach and offers you multiple different incision approaches. So anyway, I hope this helps you, and thanks.